In one of the first missions of Red Dead Redemption 2, your buddy Charles teaches you how to hunt deer.
You're never too old to learn, I imagine.
He shows you how to pick out a trail in the snow.
Keep down. Move quietly and slowly.
You creep along slowly, making sure not to lose the telltale tracks. You learn to tune your senses and stay downwind from your prey.
Focus.
When you get close enough, you take aim and whistle. The deer starts up straight, and in that split second just before it dashes away, you loose your arrow on its exposed flank.
Got it. Well done.
When it falls, you can lash it to your horse and bring it back to camp. If you're already carrying a carcass, you can skin it in the field. In that mission, Red Dead 2 teaches you that the hunt requires planning, skill, and patience. But it's not true.
Use a gun, and we'll scare off every animal for miles around.
The first time you go hunting on your own, you realize that these dumbass deer don't have a contingency plan for predators with fast horses, generous auto aim, and a max pain bullet time meter. You'll have this revelation more than once. In mission after mission, you'll be introduced to new activities with detailed, methodical mechanics. You'll learn how to fish, gather herbs, make predator bait, herd sheep and cattle. Then you'll learn that those activities don't really work the way the game says they do, and that you probably don't need to do them ever again. But their methodical approach extends to all of the stuff you can't avoid. Things like picking up ammo, purchasing individual cans of beans, grooming your horse, grooming your Arthur, riding long-ass distances, skinning deer, again and 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 again. This game has too much shit in it. In the days and weeks after Red Dead 2's launch, I played it a lot. I had fun, and quite often I was awed by its beauty. I was also frustrated, nearly all the time. I think that frustration was so pronounced because this was clearly a product made by unbelievably talented craftspeople, but it was full of unstuck landings. It was one of those oddly unsatisfying Reddit posts, except it was 70 hours long. A couple of years back, Nakey Jakey made an incredible teardown of the fundamental design flaws in Red Dead Redemption 2, and you should really go watch it. Yeah, right now. It's only 40 minutes long, and I gotta take care of some chores, so we got time.
Try to take a different route, mission failed. Try to flank the enemy, mission failed.
Why did I ever think I could do something on my own? I'm a dumb baby. I'm just a dumb baby.
Tap X a bunch and ride to a mission point and then watch a cutscene and then, uh-oh, no, wait, what? Something went wrong. The words I'm thinking of are lack of control and or spit. It's a boat and it's also a spaceship. I don't know, I was crazy as a kid.
Yeah, what he said. Beneath the inherent frustration of seeing a great thing not quite come together, there was a deeper, angrier frustration. Crunch at Rockstar and pretty much every major game dev was a documented reality. In Jason Schreier's RDR2 report, devs shared stories of working nights and weekends of mandatory overtime to squash bugs and implement the game's hundreds of ultra-detailed features. When I was playing, I would catch myself getting righteously indignant. I'd engage with a new, meticulous, not quite baked mechanic and think, this probably should have been cut. I thought that its strongest feature was its sprawling story and amazing performances.
Maybe when your mother's finished mourning your father, I'll keep her in black on your behalf.
The writing and characters stand head and shoulders above anything else Rockstar has made, but none of those strengths were enhanced by its obsessive mechanical verisimilitude. In fact, those things made it worse. My ideal version of Red Dead 2 was one that scrapped anything that got between the player and Arthur's big, beautiful, burly story. Unskippable skinning animation? Scrap it. Bathing with limb-specific scrubbing controls? Scrap it. Putting together appropriate seasonal outfits? Worky, 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 worky. You can stay. I blew through the game and lingered for a while in its lengthy epilogue. It feels reductive to summarize something so massive with words like good and bad, so I'll say I deeply appreciated all the parts that didn't drive me insane. And when I evicted all 100 gigabytes of it from my PlayStation hard drive, I had no intention of playing it again. But then I played it again. In the years since 2018, I like to think I've grown as a person, but more importantly, as a gamer. I beat games I thought would be way too hard for me, and I got lost in games I thought would be way too finicky. I spent hours and hours doing objectively tedious shit. In Project Zomboid, I would huddle in a corner, ripping t-shirts into strips to bandage an infected wound. In Subnautica, I'd devote an evening to building a machine that could turn the bad type of water into the good type of water. In Sons of the Forest, I would fall into a lumberjacking fugue, meticulously clearing brush, splitting logs, laying foundations, and eventually waking up in a three-story Lakeview cabin. For years, I would dip my toe into these grittier gaming experiences and then run off. But when I finally committed to diving in, I found that that stuff that looked boring was actually pretty compelling. So with new Rockstar stuff on the horizon and my newly acquired appreciation for the methodical, I thought that maybe I was ready to reevaluate the parts of Red Dead Redemption 2 that had rubbed me the wrong way. I would commit to engaging with the game the way the devs had intended. I was going to roleplay. I decided to mostly play in first person, hoping that it would help me appreciate the detail in the world. I would turn off the minimap and navigate by compass. I knew from experience that I didn't need to carefully stalk my prey, but Arthur would do it that way, so I would too. I would feed and groom my horse, not to maximize his stamina, but because I like my horse. Choosing to roleplay helped me appreciate things that I missed. One of the more disappointing elements in Red Dead 2's grand design was the camp. It was seemingly intended to be the emotional and mechanical center of the game, but they forgot to like plug it in, mechanically speaking. You could see the camp's food and medicine levels, and there was a communal fund that Arthur and his comrades were instructed to contribute to. But whether you pulled your weight or not didn't matter. There were never any noticeable repercussions, and the story would unfold exactly the same. But I wasn't here as a gamer, I was Arthur. I would provide for the camp because it was my responsibility to my family. Each time I returned, I'd drop off supplies and spare cash. I'd get my daily serving of stew and pace around the caravan sipping coffee. And that mechanical investment yielded emotional dividends. During my visits, I'd mingle with my outlaw compatriots. They'd comment on things that had happened on recent missions, share intel on possible jobs, and thank me for bringing them treats or taking them fishing.
Those trees had it coming, huh?
The camp gives these characters space to feel like people. We overhear their conversations, arguments, and songs. We can even sing along.
But the ocean ain't whiskey and I ain't no nut. So I'll play Jack of Diamonds and then we'll get drunk. Oh baby, oh baby.
As hours passed, I started to feel closer to my outlaw family and grew to appreciate Rockstar's ability to create nuanced and deeply flawed characters. Bill Williamson is a blowhard jerk in the first Red Dead, and he's the same in Red Dead 2, but when you've seen him get drunk and weepy or sheepishly ask you to bring him some pomade from town, you start to see the insecurity beneath the bluster.
Excuse me?
You know, hair pomade.
No.
And then there's Uncle. Every single time this guy opens his mouth in a story cutscene, it's like, why do they keep this loser around?
Now you used to be decent company, but now you're worse than a snake with a toothache. All he does is whine, whine, whine.
Excuse me.
But when you spend a few nights drinking around the campfire, you start to understand. He's great at the banjo, and he knows a lot of really bawdy songs.
When I was just glad you know, I met a gal from old Bordeaux. She had blonde hair and blue eyes too. Let me ride on ring-dang-doo,
ring-dang-doo. Even grumpy old Arthur can appreciate that. It's not just great writing that makes the camp work. It's performance, design, and animation. Here, all of that obsessive, nitpicky detail actually helps. When Uncle finishes a stirring banjo performance, the thing doesn't just pop out of his hand. There's a seamless animation, and it feels real. It helped me buy into the emotional reality of my cowboy crime family, and pretty soon I found myself voluntarily engaging in Red Dead's most menial tasks. Stuff like splitting logs, moving bags of grain, and haying the horses. From a mechanical standpoint, none of that does anything, but I was doing it anyways. For a while, role-playing worked, and it helped me appreciate Red Dead 2 like I never had. Absorbing the sights and sounds and getting to know the characters was the emotional reward for playing along with Rockstar's intended playstyle. But it wouldn't last, because this immersion was all carrot and no stick. After a dozen or so hours, when my patience for sluggish mechanics had grown thin, I fell back into bad habits.
Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I went back to camp and saw our food supplies in the red, so I galloped away from camp and Max Payne blasted a couple of deer from horseback. I started fast traveling more. I stopped helping out at camp. And there were never consequences. Gradually, my self-motivated bubble of immersion eroded. My appreciation gave way to new irritations, and I started to get really, really grumpy about guns. This Cattleman revolver is based on the Colt 1873 single action. The interesting thing about a single action revolver is that nothing happens when you pull the trigger. Doesn't matter how many times or how hard you pull, the thing won't fire until you've cocked the hammer. The rigid mechanics of the single action pistol have always dictated the way action unfolds in westerns.
You said the man with the pistol's a dead man.
The anticipatory cocking of the hammer.
Let's see if that's true.
And the familiar click-bang firing pattern. Fanning the hammer is an iconic cowboy life hack that manipulates the single action mechanism to shoot irresponsibly fast. It's gun overclocking. Now, if I were going to implement a single action revolver in a video game, I'd go one of two paths. The first is to cheat. Remove a bit of unneeded friction and magically make all of the single action weapons function as double action. That's what the first Red Dead Redemption did. Each time you'd pull R2 on your controller, the pistol would fire. This is a big simplification, but games simplify weapon mechanics all the time, especially when they're targeting a broad audience. The other option would be to lean into the complexity. Let's say, theoretically, you have to push square or click the thumbstick between every shot, mimicking the alternating thumb and index motion of a single-action revolver. That's kind of a pain in the ass, but you've created opportunities for developing skill, and just as importantly, room for failure.
Put an oven on there. Oh, we're out of them. That's enough, I guess.
I've been playing a couple of VR survival action games lately, where that pairing of skill and failure adds so much excitement. When I get jumped by a gang of creepy shadow ghouls and into the radius, I can fire my shotgun, offhand it, then clean up with my sidearm. Or maybe I tried to do that, but the gun doesn't shoot because I left the safety on, and then I panic and accidentally eject the magazine, and I have to scramble to get it back in the gun before I get fully gooped. Red Dead 2's solution to the single action revolver is neither of these things, and I think it exemplifies one of Rockstar's most frustrating design tendencies. When you aim the Cattleman revolver with the left trigger, Arthur kindly cocks the hammer. Thank you, Arthur. When you pull the right trigger, Arthur pulls the trigger and the gun goes off. Simple enough. But each shot after that first freebie is going to take two inputs. One to cock the hammer, and one to pull the trigger. And I don't mean two buttons, you just have to mash right trigger over and over again. To cock, then fire, and cock, and fire, and I swear to God I'm nearly done saying cock. Each time you pull that trigger, the game decides for you what that input should mean. That turns it into a mechanic that is impossible to excel at, impossible to fail at, and impossible to ignore. Like so many parts of Red Dead Redemption 2, it feels like Rockstar is forcing you to acknowledge complexity without giving you the opportunity to experience it yourself. Swapping between Red Dead 2 and proper survival games, I realized that consequence is the thing that makes the difference between tedium and tactics. In Red Dead 2, shooting your guns wears them down. To keep them in tip-top shape, you can polish them up with gun oil or take them to a shop for maintenance. You can buy special holsters to reduce degradation. But what happens if you don't care? I don't know. Your guns get a mostly imperceptible stat penalty, but I never once saw one jam or break. Cleaning them takes a second, but it's annoying every time. Everywhere you look, it's complexity without consequence. Cleaning my guns in radius is way slower and more involved, but never boring, because I know that if I bring a dirty gun on my next mission, it's gonna jam up and it'll be a whole thing. When I feed Arthur a tin of beans, it's to refill his stamina meter so that I can sprint for longer, but it's mostly so that I don't need to look at an empty meter. In Subnautica, my hunger and thirst meters aren't an annoyance, they are a mortal threat, and a constant motivator. Even as you build mechanical wonders and witness the unfathomable beauties and terrors of the deep, your rumbly tummy is right there to keep you on task. I can't help but wonder how different Red Dead 2 would feel if the survival mechanics were a bit more brutal and if the planning, skill, and patience in that tutorial hunt was more than a suggestion. Roleplaying mechanics and roleplaying emotions go hand in hand. If one half of that loop is broken, you're gonna fall out eventually. When I look at Red Dead Redemption 2, all I can see are the two nearly perfect games it could have been, if Rockstar had dramatically simplified it, or committed to its complexity. But as it is, I'll be perfectly happy waiting another 5 years to check in again.